Hello.
Have the best coffee in the city.
I like such places. The atmosphere is unique.
Isn't it? And maybe you'd like some hibiscus tea. We also have green tea and ginger infusion. If you'd like a cool drink, there is lime juice. And we offer such delicacies, sweet baklava and basbousa. There are also full medames or tamia sandwiches. How about some matzah?
I'd rather talk than eat.
To anybody in particular? I know everybody here.
Do you know any art collectors?
Oh, such people don't come here. We have a different kind of customer. Storekeepers, barbers, modest people, but a night with them is a feast for the spirit.
No doubt.
Hig Ismail, he's able to distinguish 15 different flavors in simple full.
What is full?
Ordinary cooked beans. And nazir?
Is that another dish?
Oh, it's good he can't hear you. You'd become the heroine of his caustic stories. His mother-in-law would be relieved, though.
I'd rather you didn't tell him about it.
It's not that simple. Soon they're going to come here. Say hello, start playing backgammon, call they want tea or coffee or something else, though they've been ordering the same things for ages. And then they're going to say, Hassan, caravan routes cross by your cafe. Have you had any news from the outside world?
Oh, my.
Oh, my. So what should I tell them? Can I tell them that caravans go another way and that not a living thing has showed up here?
They wouldn't feel content.
Precisely. So you understand. I wait the whole day for the leavening, for the grain from which a tail will grow.
And here I come?
Oh, a European that mistakes nazir for full.
What a blunder.
It's not a blunder. It's a good beginning. But what should I tell them about the collector they're supposed to look for?
They're supposed to look for him?
Oh, you Europeans are so amusing. You think you discovered the net.
www.
Do you think I have the time to run around the city, grab people's sleeves, and ask them about a collector I know nothing about?
I'm not asking you to do anything like this.
I have no time for that, and I don't have to do it. We have a net that's been working for thousands of years. In the evening, I'll tell the regulars about your collector, then they'll go back home and tell their brothers, brothers-in-law, uncles, wives, mothers-in-law, grandmothers, and tomorrow, 40,000 people in Cairo will be looking for your collector. This is the net.
Oh my God.
Allah is great.
I would like to keep it low profile.
And why is that? You have to make up your mind.
Because I don't know that man. He could feel offended.
He should be happy. Publicity helps in business, unless it's foul business. There are lots of collectors in Cairo. What does he collect? Mummies?
I know he's interested in relics from Atlantis.
Atlantis? Here in Egypt?
This place is better than many others.
Great. And they don't know that.
That it's better?
And maybe Ahmed, the horn virtuoso, is beeping because he's realized he's in the wrong traffic jam and that he won't make it with the goods he's delivering. And in the evening, when he sits depressed at the table, he will hear someone say that Egypt is better than many other places. And then Tariq will stand up and say that, in his opinion, this whole Atlantis theory is a slight to Egyptian national pride. And Yusuf will mumble that he's not sure if somebody who supports Zamalek can bring up national pride.
Oof, what a mess.
A mess? No, it's just a plant that's grown from the grain thrown by a European. Lonely and lost in this city.
Wait a minute. My uncle knew an...
Enter the uncle.
Antiquary here? What was his name?
If you aren't married, your uncle's name is the same as yours.
The antiquaries. Do you know any?
Oh, yes. It's almost a plebeian job. One of my regulars is an antiquary. He sits at that table. But now, he's surely reveling in the smell of his books.
Where can I find his book paradise?
In a den by the citadel. Go straight ahead, and then you'll see the marketplace.
Goodbye.
Come back and tell me how it went.
Do you know a man called Saint Germain?
No. Who is he?
A count.
Ah, I wish I had such connections.
See ya.
It was a pleasure to talk to you.
Maybe the antiquary has appropriate connections. I need to see him. Will I find what I'm looking for in this marketplace? Reminds me of my last journey to Istanbul. That colossal medieval building must give a lot of shade in the morning. A terrific location for a market. An antique lover can dig out something precious in here. Hello.
Greetings. I can see you want to buy something.
Can I enter and have a look around?
Praise the Lord, I've recently bought so many items that it's impossible to get inside. I've got old tomes, parchments, French sabers dug up under the pyramids, ancient cat statues, and a nose.
Yes, in this line of business, you have to be able to smell a rat.
It's Cleopatra's nose, of course!
My uncle mentioned you're a joker.
Oh my, I'm getting famous and a bit senile. Have we met?
No, I don't think so. My uncle used to contact you. He was an archaeologist. My name is Sylvie Leroux.
Ah, Leroux.
My uncle's name was Olivier.
Yes, I remember him. Died, poor thing. I used to search for some old books for him. I met him many years ago when he was digging in the Valley of the Kings.
I liked the envelopes you put your letters in.
Are you going to stay in Cairo for long?
I don't know yet. I'm looking for a collector.
A collector? And what do you do?
Just like my uncle, I'm an archaeologist. Apart from that, I like restoring old items.
There are plenty of collectors here. They come and go, bring objects and take them away.
You probably know all of them?
Many.
Apparently, that collector can be found in the old town. He's interested in the archaeology of Atlantis.
Ha! Does something like that exist at all?
If not, then he stands out even more, don't you think?
Good point. But now I have to find someone to help me empty my storage room. I'll ask about him some other time.
Please help me, for the sake of my uncle.
When I find this collector, where should I leave a message for Sylvie Leroux?
In that boarding house in the back street. Tell the boy it's for the foreigner. He may not remember my name.
Ah, you're staying where little Ali's in charge now.
Yes, his parents have left. He's doing a great job. When will you know anything?
In a hurry?
A bit.
A business of a lifetime, hmm?
I hope it works out.
So you're probably very busy.
What do you mean?
No, I don't want to invite you for dinner. Too old for that. I have another idea.
Yes?
You're impatient. The business of a lifetime's waiting and nothing's happening. I have a little job for you.
Should I dig something up?
Now you are joking. Will you have a look?
A silk scarf. Pretty, but terribly soiled and clotted with blood.
Right. And I'm afraid to touch it so as not to damage it.
I can try. And you'll ask around?
I can try as well. What's the harm in it?
I wonder who's going to do their job first.
You're going to do the job faster than I would have, while you'd be doing what I usually succeed in.
Ah, are you trying to say that I'm a better restorer than you?
No doubt about that.
So it's a deal. Goodbye.
Ah, my back's killing me.
Whether?
Whether I want it or not. But you're as old as you feel, right?
Bye.
Goodbye.
It must be a tight squeeze inside since he won't let me in. I hope he does his best to find the collector. First, I need to remove the dry blood. Blood and ink have clotted the old silk. Washing by hand is the most reliable. I'm not going to walk around with a wet scarf in my pocket. I should hang it somewhere to dry. There's no sign of blood.